This morning, I'll be taking you through on this live broadcast. This is the Imo State, the popular Imo State government has round about, you know, where the capital city of Imo State. This morning, this spot is deserted, and this is how it is in all the nooks and crannies of where the Imo State capital. This is aftermath of the cancellation of weekly sit at home as declared by the indigenous people of Biafra. Despite that, residents of Owerri, the Imo State capital, have continued to sit at home every Monday. And today's own is not any different, as almost all the residents of this city are sitting back home. On a normal day, this very spot would have been filled with activities, vehicles. We'd have seen traffic gridlock. We'd have seen people going through the government house and through the police command headquarters, and through this Okigwe Road, the popular Wedra Road, and the bank road leading through to Warehouse Junction and to Control. But this morning, the entire city is deserted. This morning at the Ikenebu area of the state capital, young men and women were seen by me playing football on a major road where ordinarily cars were supposed to be plying through. That is to tell you that Owerri is a shadow of its own. Owerri is a shadow of itself this morning. Everybody is sitting back home. This is against the backdrop of what happened 2 weeks ago Monday, when there was a stampede after news broadcast that some hoodlums were going to schools and various markets enforcing a sit-at-home order. People quickly rushed to schools and withdrew their children and work from school. After that day, and on that day too, a DSS personnel serving here in Imo State was also shot dead along the way on HR Road. After that day, the subsequent Mondays, which was the last Monday and today's Monday, have witnessed a total compliance with the sit-at-home order, despite its cancellation by the indigenous people of Biafra. Many residents are fearful. Many residents are of the opinion that it is better for them to sit back in their homes, enjoy with their families, their children, and their works, than to come out on a Monday and be faced with the unknown. That is why Mondays now are deserted in Owerri. Almost all the markets are shut down, more especially the independent markets are driven through major streets in Owerri this morning. The markets are shut down. There are no schools. There are no schools in operation this morning. On Friday, all the private schools told parents and guardians not to bring their children and wards to school today, Monday. They told parents that the thing is because of safety measure. At a Madonna Secondary School, at a works layout, it was specifically written on the notice board that for safety reasons, for security reasons, that all parents and guardians should not bring their children to school on Monday, rather they should bring them to school on Tuesday. And that is how it is in all the private schools in Owerri, the Imo State capital. It is now a long weekend in Owerri, the Imo State capital, as various transport companies have been counting losses on Mondays, as people now have refused to travel on Mondays, owing to what the tragic developments that have happened in previous Mondays in Owerri. You will recall that last two weeks Monday, two vehicles were set ablaze on Owerri Omaha Road at Ayala Junction and Afiyogu respectively. And in that process, a driver of one of the buses was burnt and he died. And 5 weeks ago, on a Monday too, six vehicles were attacked on Owerri Omaha Road, at Mbi said to be more precise again, where two of the travelers were burnt and they died. So this development has continued to to send and continue to bring panic in the state. People now say for safety measures, it is better for them to sit back home than to come out on Mondays and be attacked. Despite the obvious reason that Owerri has remained the ghost of itself on Mondays, the government of Imo State has continued to insist that the residents of the state do not comply with the sit at home on Mondays. But with what you are seeing on this screen this morning, you will agree with me that the sit at home compliance in Owerri, the Imo State capital, is maximum, as very few persons are seen trekking and just few vehicles are seen plying through the roads, unlike what it used to be on a normal Monday, where this place would have been a beehive of commercial activities, people traveling, people trading, and shops opening, and corporate offices opening for the day's engagement. But a Monday morning like this, the Owerri is a shadow of itself. From the government has roundabout in Owerri, the Imo State capital.
Wonderful people of Biafra, lovers of freedom all over the world. The reason why we are doing this thing is for avoidance of doubt. You all know how hopeless Uzodinjo, the Supreme Court Fulani administrator of Imo State, always come online to debunk the effort of Biafrans for pressing home the release of our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu in Imo State, especially in Owerri. That man is full of lies and deceit. This is, for avoidance of doubt, this is the video, you have seen it. It is not picture. Today's date is 18th of October 2021. This is not cinema. This is live and direct, live video from Owerri, the city center, the capital city of Imo State. So if that hopeless idiot comes tomorrow with his propaganda to tell you, people of Imo State do not obey it at home, debunk, in fact, throw him either pure water or stone. That man is a thief. He is an idiot. His duty is to please his slave and paymasters from Asorok. That is his duty. Nothing else. He doesn't care about the welfare of his people. Although Biafrans are not his people, his people are from Sokoto. He is not different from Rocha Sokora Osa. The only difference there is that he is a representative of slavery. He represents slavery. So, but at least Rocha Sokora won an election. But his own, he came from the back door and sworn an oath to destroy Imo State. He has killed more than 2,000 youths in Imo State. These are the difference between him and the Rocha Sokora Osa. But in terms of human nature, they are all the same. Propagandists. They only know how to lie to try and, protect the interest of their slave masters. They don't care about the people. Look at Owerri. The picture you are seeing now is live. The video have already played. This is not propaganda. Today, this morning in Owerri, you can see it. But somebody will come tomorrow or even this evening to tell you, Imo State does not obey sit at home. What a lie. In fact, let me put the record straight. Imo State ranks number 2, the highest observers of sit at home after Anambra State. Because every Monday is under lockdown, Olu is under lockdown, Okigwe is under lockdown, everywhere, Mbanombise, Uguta, Ebema, everywhere, name it. The same thing in Anambra State, Onitsha, Oka, Ihiala, Nnewi, name them, everywhere is always under lockdown. Then now followed by, Enugu State, Abia State, then Ebonyi State, Delta State, and River State. These are the most states that observe sit at home, mostly. But you will see a coward who paraded himself as the governor of Imo State come to, you know, to media to lie. I got the one can go off. Keep this very video for record purposes. It is today, 18th of October, 2021. Sit at home continues. Thank you, the people of Imo State. Thank you, Biafrans all over the world. Share this news and make it go viral.